We will learn how to make some Canadian pancakes with maple syrup and some bacon. So, we already put two eggs inside it. So you have to put two eggs and 1.5 cups of mix, pancake mix. So we will put the half. Then you have to put 1.5 cups of milk. And then you have to mix it until it gets quite liquidy, you know, soft. So you guys have to continue mixing it until it's smooth and bubbles. So let's go and see the bacon. So the bacon, you put the stove on with a medium degrees and you start cooking the bacon. When you think it's, depends how you like it, you either want it crispy or soft, like not crispy, which means you either cook it for a long time. So when you think it's crispy enough from one side, you flip it over.
Who discovered maple syrup?
Oh, there's a legend says that there's a Native American, when a chief went out to get some food, he saw a moose and he threw his tomahawk. He missed the moose, but it landed into a maple tree. And then he saw the maple tree, the syrup, come out of the maple tree. And that's how they found maple syrup.
No.
Hi.
How much maple syrup produced in Canada?
Canada produced 85% of maple syrup every year.
Ahora?
So, hey, chef of bacon.
Yeah.
How is the bacon doing?
It's good.
Do you have any bacon ready?
Yeah.
You have bacon ready? Ah, perfect. So, some Canadians put maple syrup on their bacon. So it's up to you if you like maple syrup. It's very sweet and very tasty. Hey, do you want to try some bacon because we already have some ready with maple syrup?
Okay. Thank you.
Try with maple syrup, it's so good. Is it good?
How old does a maple tree have to be before to be tapped?
Oh, the maple tree has to be 40 years old before it can be tapped. So it's a long time. When you asked me that question, the tree can produce maple syrup over decades. But the thing is, the tree can only produce its maple syrup mid-February and mid-March. Because if you hit it too early, it won't be enough developed. And if you hit it too late, there's not enough flavor. So it's very precise. Because the maple tree has to be you have to be very precise when you have to tap it. So when you're ready, because you mixed a lot, you have to take some butter, really rub it onto the stove. Then you have to take a full spoonful.
Not too full. Okay.
And pour it. Yeah. Like hard commit like that. Then normally on your pan you can. Now you can normally can maybe do 2 or 3 pancakes per pan. Depends the size of your pan. keyboard. Then you wait for the bubbles, which there are. So you have to go under, and when you flip, you have to commit. Commit. Now let me put under. Yes. And you have to commit. If you don't commit, you will maybe make it move, and then the mix of the pancakes will maybe won't go well, like Aziz. Then you have to wait a minute and it should be ready. So now the pancakes are ready. So you can put maple syrup, of course. You want some? And you can always, for people that like, put some cinnamon, which is really good too. So when you're ready, you can start eating. How do you think the pancakes are?
Fine.
I love them. So I hope you guys liked the video. This is how you make some Canadian pancakes with bacon and maple syrup, of course. Adrian, it's your first time eating pancakes. How do you think it's, how it is? How
I
is
love it?
It. You love the pancakes?
Yes.
And what about the bacon?
I love it too.
Okay. Bye.